Previously on Red Band Society.
You just gave me niplash. This water sucks. It tastes like pee.
Why is it that the two most eligible bachelors can only sport wood for a bag of bones?
And I broke things off, and I regretted it.
I'm ready to put the past behind us if you are. Friends?
Friends.
Hey.
Look, I had an amazing time, but it's a little strange that you tracked me down to work.
I am visiting my son.
Who's your son?
Mom?
We were under the impression that you had passed away.
She's dead to me.
Maybe your mom being here is actually a good thing. Research shows that patients have a much better chance of survival when they have someone close to them by their side. I hear you're sticking around for a while.
It looks that way.
My dad once told me that going home is never as easy or simple as we predict. Like stepping into the same river twice. You never know what awaits you when you walk through that door. Because going home means facing everything you left behind. Maybe you left glory and fame. Or maybe you left friends. Or maybe you never had any to begin with. Or maybe you simply acquired too much baggage along the way. But the thing about home is that we can't stop hoping it will always be exactly as we left it.
You only brought two bags for the most important night of my life?
I'm sorry. It's all I could carry on my bike.
Then get a bigger bike. We're going to homecoming, not a yoga class.
Nobody even cares what you're wearing tonight. Everyone just misses you.
Sell that sunshine somewhere else. We both know that absence does not make the heart grow fonder. It just makes people forget about you.
Luckily, my stay in this hellhole is temporary. I just need to get back to school and remind people that I'm still in charge. I'm sure it'll be perfect. Just like last year's homecoming. Oops. Now all we have to do is figure out your exit strategy.
Just keep unpacking. I have my own plan dealing with Nurse Ratchet.
Lose something?
Yep. All of my soccer skills. My kick, my dribbling.
Leo, you just started physical therapy. Regaining that kind of agility could take months.
I don't have months. I got an email this morning from the Stanford athletic recruiter, and he says he saw me play last fall, and he wants me on their team next year. But he doesn't know what happened to me. You know, about my leg. If I don't have soccer, I don't get a scholarship. If I don't get a scholarship, I don't go to college.
Well, you're walking, aren't you?
What does that have to do with anything?
It wasn't so long ago you were worried you'd never walk again.
Walking is one thing. Playing Division I soccer is next level. There's no PT at Ocean Park that can train me like that.
Who said you had to train in the hospital? You do some research, I'll make some calls.
I seriously want to hug you right now.
You'll get over it.
Online shopping?
I broke up with my boyfriend, so I was switching my relationship status to single.
Jesus, are you all right?
Me? Oh, yeah, I'm great. So I left my friends and my family and moved out here to be with him. So what? Life happens, right?
Well, best part about this job is it never stops. You immerse yourself in your work, and before you know it, you won't even remember his name.
It's Ben. His name was Ben.
Jordy, I'm here.
Hi. Thought you were coming this morning.
I know, I'm sorry, but I stopped to pick this up for you.
I saw it in Sex and the City when Samantha had cancer. Thank God for HBO.
What's with your outfit?
I was at a job interview.
You already have a job as a waitress in Fresno.
Pretty tough commute to LA, huh?
Mom, you don't have to.
Look, when you get out, we'll have an apartment. I'll have a great job, and this whole ordeal will just be a blip on our radar.
And what if I never get out?
You will.
You don't know that.
Yes, I do.
How?
Because I am your mother, and I said so. So, let me do the worrying. You just focus on getting better, okay?
Last time you flexed your jaw muscles. Yeah, why aren't you eating with your Rexo friends over there?
They're not my friends.
What do you want?
I'm just wondering, who gets the rose on the latest episode of Cancer Bachelor? Is it Latino heartthrob Jordy or the hometown favorite Leo?
Well, not that it's any of your business, but I'm not into either of them.
Fine. I'm just saying, you know, don't mess with my boy Leo's head like that.
You have an unhealthy interest in Leo's dating life.
I'm just inquisitive.
Inquisitive, in love with him. Call it whatever you want.
If I was in love with him, I'd be clear about it. Because men are direct. What's up, ladies?
Say something.
I could potentially never live to see another homecoming again, which would be among the world's greatest tragedies, second only to the Titanic or Nicki Minaj's Perfume, a menagerie, or
me and Ben breaking up.
Here's Jackson. If I don't go to this homecoming, I just...
And the Oscar for the most pathetic performance in a pediatric ward goes to...
Kira, save the tears for your homecoming queen acceptance speech.
Wait, does that mean I can go?
This is a hospital, not a prison. Yes, you can go. The heart monitor, the chaperone.
Okay, this I can work with, but there's no way I'm going to homecoming with you.
How will I ever recover from such a crushing blow?
Pick me, pick me, pick me, pick me, pick me.
You can go, Brittany.
Oh, my God. What are you
doing? Where? What do you think this is, the Vegas buffet?
Is that for Jordy? You want one?
I brought you some reading materials. Now that we've identified Jordy's cancer as Ewing sarcoma, you might want to educate yourself on his condition.
Right.
Also, there's a parent support group you should look into. And I'd like to get a blood sample from you as soon as possible. It might be useful down the line, before his next surgery.
There's going to be another surgery.
At least one, possibly more. It's all in the pamphlets.
You don't like me, do you?
I like your son.
Well, I'm sorry I missed the beginning of all this, but I'm here now. And I really appreciate your help. What do you say?
The support group meets at 7 p.m. in the commissary.
Is everything okay in there? What do you think? It's pink.
That's putting it kindly.
Too much pink?
It's kind of like staring at the sun. Every time I blink, I see spots.
Dr. McAndrew was right. Immersing yourself in your work is the best way to go. Plus, I just love homecomings, don't you?
I wouldn't know. I have never been. This may come as a shock to you, but I wasn't exactly popular at my high school.
Well, it does come as a shock to me. I can't imagine anyone not liking you.
Well, liking me, I don't have to imagine it. I lived it on a daily basis.
And things are better here?
Definitely. Yeah, much better.
Ooh.
What is happening to your face?
I am having a light bulb moment. You should come with me to homecoming.
A hard pass. I would much rather stay here and stare at the walls.
That's what I'm worried about. I think you're getting too comfortable in the hospital. At some point, you're gonna have to get back out there.
This could be a good way to ease back into the social scene.
Going to a dance where I won't know a single soul.
You'll know Kara.
You'll know me.
I think it would be good for you.
Wait, do you have any medical statistics to back up this theory?
I'm not saying this as your nurse. I'm saying it as your friend.
Take it, I don't have much of a choice.
Nope.
Have you heard of the one about the nurse, the anorexic, and the cheerleader that all walk into a homecoming? Me neither.
So the closest Paralympic center with the equipment I need to train is in Chula Vista. It sounds like a donut, not a place.
It's also 3 hours away.
I know, I can't get there once a month, let alone a few times a week.
Oh, that's a good thing you don't have to.
Excuse me as I geek out, but I'm a giant fan of the Bionic Man. Ty stands for titanium, because that's what his leg's made out of. It's the strongest element in the world.
No offense, Nurse Jackson, but I'm gonna need more than a YouTube video to get back into shape.
Ty spent 2 months on our floor when he was about your age. That was before he played college ball at UCLA and then went pro in Europe. I spoke to him this morning.
You know Tim Ty Jones?
Starting next week, he's agreed to come to the hospital to train you.
Seriously? That's incredible.
You're welcome.
Novel immunohistochemistry. Techniques in cancer diagnosis. Casual afternoon reading?
Nurse Jackson gave this to me to get caught up in George's condition.
That's not getting caught up. That's what I read in my third year of oncology residency.
No kidding. I didn't know I had to go to medical school to be a mother.
You don't?
It kind of feels like it. I'm turning my whole life upside down to be here for my kid, but nobody wants me.
Jordy wants you, and you are going to get through this, right? One day at a time, like every other parent in here with a sick kid. I promise you. Now, let me borrow this for a bit. Hey, was this really necessary?
Can't a woman enjoy the simple pleasure of getting her back rubbed by a chair? I have so little.
Just do me a favor. We just lay off Eva Palacio. She's got enough to worry about without you hunting her for sport.
I was trying to educate her. And maybe if you stop listening to little McAndrew, you'd realize that woman isn't to be trusted.
I am not listening with little McAndrew. All right, I'm listening to Jordy. Jordy wants his mother around. Jordy needs his mother around.
Well, my gut tells me that woman is bad news, and my gut is never wrong.
I'm not saying she's perfect. I'm just saying she's trying.
Well, maybe she should have tried harder while she was raising him. Except she didn't raise him, did she? No, she dumped him off at Grandma's so she could do whatever she wanted. Do you know how many people would kill for the opportunity to raise their own child? The things that people will sacrifice just for the privilege of having a boy like Jordy. And that woman just gave him up like it was nothing.
People make mistakes.
It doesn't mean I have to forgive them.
It must be nice to always be so right about everything, huh?
It's my cross to bear.
I think it's time that I mention I got myself an obsession for the smell, for the touch. That's gruff looking. I know I've got myself a habit, but I gotta have it. I don't care where, work it out. Let me break it down. I try on, I take it off. So what you got? Something about boots and boys.
Thank you.
that doing here? Surprise! We're all going to homecoming together. Huh, not a chance. I'm not going, poke a hot mess. I told you this was a bad idea.
Do not let her get under your skin.
Oh, well, how could I? I would have to get past all the peach fuzz first.
Oh my God, is it on your stomach too? Are you all furry like a bear? Okay, say one more mean thing and we're leaving without you.
Hello? It's my school.
Hello? I don't care.
Oh, but she doesn't even... What? Okay, fine. Can we just go already? God.
Slow your roll, Skeletor. Just because I let you come with me does not mean that we've joined the Sisterhood of the Traveling Panties. Starting now, we're complete strangers.
For the record, I want to be here about as much as you want me to be here. Probably less.
That's not humanly possible.
Can you just wait until Brittany's finished parking the car?
I'm sorry, do I know you?
Full disclosure, I stole this out of a dead guy's room. Shall we? You could use a friend.
Yeah, this is so not my scene on every possible level. Even if it was my school, I...
Oh, but it is, really. When you think about it, isn't every high school the same, you know? I mean, where would you be right now?
Probably there. Honestly, I would be looking at my phone as if I were sending an important text, but really, I would just be reading my book.
You would be reading a book at a dance.
The Goldfinch is a literary masterpiece.
Yeah, but it's a dance.
The woman won a Pulitzer.
I say it again, it's a dance.
Moving on. I can assume you would be somewhere over there?
In that vicinity, but always looking over my shoulder.
Looking for the next best thing?
No, looking for something real. I'm thirsty. How about I go get us some refreshing, nutritious, calorie-free bottles of water?
Sounds like a plan.
Dude, you suck at this. You have no poker face whatsoever.
Maybe I do.
Maybe I don't. Okay. I call.
Whatever, man. This game is stupid.
Hey, here you are. I've been looking everywhere for you.
Well, what are you still doing here?
I have a parents' meeting tonight. How you feeling, Jojo?
Not great, but on the upside, I haven't puked yet.
Then why don't you have fun while you're still up for it? Go to the movies with your friend. Have some popcorn, buy some ices. Do whatever you want.
Seriously?
Better take this before I change my mind.
Dude, your mom's kind of awesome, man.
You hear that?
Easy.
I'm kind of awesome.
All right, let's go. You gonna be here when I get back?
I got nowhere else to be.
You look exactly like Beyonce's Caucasian little sister.
Do you wear my lip gloss?
Of course, but there are much more pressing matters we need to discuss.
Wait, what the hell? Did you not tell Quimby I was wearing sequins?
I texted everyone.
I thought this is exactly what I was talking about. Things are already spiraling way out of control.
Okay, but we really need to talk.
I can't talk right now. I need to go in there and assert my power.
This is what you call a knife fight in Beverly Hills. First blood to the blonde.
I totally ruined your dress. I hope you brought an extra one.
Kara Sauters. Ew, you look amazed. Guys, doesn't she look amazed?
Okay, this is weird.
Welcome back, girlfriend.
It's good to be back, bitches.
And all is right in Kara's world. Or is it?
Yo, Ross.
Dave, what up?
You're alive.
Last time I checked.
Hey, it's good to see you, dude.
Yeah.
You look...
bald.
Yeah, but cool bald.
Okay.
Sorry if that came out weird. It's just I haven't seen you since,
cancer?
I was going to say Modesto Nationals.
Oh, right, when I make you for the win in overtime, yeah.
So what are you doing here? You going to come to the school next semester?
No, I'm just crashing with some friends from the hospital.
I didn't realize you were still sick.
I'm not. I'm stronger than ever. I'm just getting a few kinks worked out of my new leg. And I should be back on the fields by playoffs.
Cool. Yeah, your team can really use some of your fighting spirit.
My spirit? Dude, what about my corner kicks?
Yeah, sure, those too. Yeah, I'm glad your team made a place for
you. They didn't make a place. My team saved my space so that they could watch me humiliate you in front of your team, like I did last season.
It's great seeing you.
Can we talk to you for a minute? Am I sitting in your seats? I'm so sorry, I can move.
Oh my God. She looks even better when she stands.
What?
Well, it's just that we've never seen a size 000 before in the flesh.
You're a real unicorn. Rare and beautiful.
Thank you.
So what's your secret? 2 cardio classes on Wednesday, Tabata boot camp, visual eating on Monday, green juice on Friday, and no food on Sundays?
No, actually, I was diagnosed with an eating disorder. I live at Ocean Park Hospital.
You're so committed.
I just don't have the discipline for that.
We need to get a picture.
You are gonna be Insta-famous.
Okay. Smile.
With friends like these, Emma might be better off sitting alone.
Man, you all right?
Oh, chemo's gnarly. I feel like ass.
Hey, man. At least they got you in a regimen that lets you keep all your head. Like our ball friend, Leo. Homeboy looks like Professor Xavier or something, man.
He's even got the wheelchair.
Oh, snap. Speaking of Leo, actually, Emma and Leo, how you feel about that whole sitch, man?
Ah, that's why you've been hanging out with me today. You're not interested in being my friend. You're interested in protecting your friendship with Leo, and you're trying to get dirt on me for him.
Nah, man, look, I got no problem with you. I'm just trying to get a lay of the land, that's all.
All right, well, the lay of the land is... my life is weirdly stable for the first time in basically forever. My mom's around, and I have friends that I actually like, including you. Not about to ruin that over a girl.
Cool. Bro code.
Red band code.
Mm. It must be weird having your mom come around and be all mom on you after, you know, you've been on your own.
Yeah, that's kind of what she does. Being a mom for her is like going on a camping trip. No, I'm serious. She gets all excited and buys all the equipment, and then 2 days into it, she wishes that she was back in the hotel.
She came around when you needed her most. Seems to me like she rarely wants to go camping, bro.
You better have some good popcorn here, or else I'm going home.
Oh my gosh, you're here. I just want to thank you for being such an inspiration. I'm glad we could put the past behind us now. I'm sorry, I don't know why you think it's okay to be talking to me. I love you so much.
Oh my God, someone needs to go break the rest of the bent girl's spine because she literally just raped me.
You mean Anna? Poor thing, she's been through so much. Just like you.
Just like who?
Here's where it all goes dark.
Also, she's been super helpful with your presentation.
What presentation?
Okay, it was supposed to be a surprise, but I can give you a sneak peek.
Kara is the kindest, most generous, patient human I've ever met. It's such a tragedy that this had to happen to her. She was so beautiful, and her heart is so broken. I mean,
what?
Kara was loved by ballets and old people. and homeless people and all people.
Why are you doing this?
Because you're really sick and you might die. We feel super duper bad for you.
What?
And just like that, it went from a homecoming party to a pity party.
Take care. Bye.
Hey. Hey, did you give Jordy permission to go to the movies?
Not only did I give him permission, I gave him $50.
Who told you you can do that? You can't just let a sick kid walk out of a hospital.
I seem fine.
He's not fine. He has cancer. He has a million different chemicals coursing through his body. He needs rest. Next time you want to do something nice for him, just consult with me first.
I'm sorry. I didn't know.
All right, it's okay. It's okay. I know it's been a long day, all right?
It sure has. In fact, I could use a drink. You're interested?
No, I have rounds.
It's okay. What time do you get off?
Eva, I thought we both agreed that this can't happen again.
But you keep sending me mixed signals.
I'm sorry, I don't... Let's keep the focus on Jerry, okay?
Yeah.
I understand what you were trying to do today, trying to make him happy. Things are gonna get harder before they get easier. Right, there's not always gonna be a quick fix, all right?
Why don't you be his doctor and let me be his mother? Stupid. Oh, thank you. Are you having fun?
Yeah. Well, late.
Hey, where are you going?
I'm getting out of here. Everyone in this hell coming is obsessed with me and my heart problem.
What's wrong with that? I thought you liked being the center of attention.
Yeah, not this kind of attention. I used to walk down these halls like I was freaking Moses. The crowd would part at my feet, but now everyone is coming up to me and talking to me, hugging me.
You know that's because they care about you.
Screw that noise. I'd rather be feared than loved.
Who are you, Tony Soprano? I mean, come on, what kind of philosophy is that?
Look, you might get off on being Mr. Cancer Boy, bald poster child, legless man, but the one thing I'm not okay with is being pitied. Greetings, fellow Vikings. It is with great honor and humbleness, Eddie, that I announce Paradise Cove High's 2014 homecoming queen, Kara Sauders.
Come in.
Okay, walk.
Actually, for insurance purposes, we're going to need you to go ahead and take a seat.
Not quite the chariot she was expecting.
How's it going?
Fine.
I know I've flooded you with material. So if you have questions, I'm happy to walk you through anything.
Do you think I'm some kind of moron?
Just trying to help.
Hmm.
I'm sorry if I came across harsh earlier.
Harsh? Lady, I can handle harsh. What I can't handle is condescending or rude. Tell me, do you have any keys of your own?
I don't. But I do what I can for the kids here at the hospital.
You might be a great nurse, but you don't know what it's like to be a mother. I don't need anybody's help.
Hi. Where you been?
Hi, I just met these girls. This is Brooklyn, and that's Becky.
Hi, how you doing?
Okay.
You smell like smoke.
Brooklyn smokes, and I went outside with her, so.
Welcome, students, to Paradise Cove's most heartfelt crowning ceremony yet. I ask you what makes a queen. Courage, fearlessness, kindness, and an acne-free complexion. Kara Stouders is all of these things, but what is most special about Kara is her heart. And before we crown her queen of our hearts, Paradise Cove Spirited Cheer Squad has put together a tribute video to honor Kara.
Hey, hold on, one sec, I gotta say something.
I know how you feel. Once you start the love, it's hard to stop. Come on up here, son.
A few words on Kara Stouders. I've only known her for 5 days. But what I've learned is that 5 days with Kara is 5 days too many. Because Kara is the biggest bitch I've ever met in my entire life.
Get this slideshow going, please.
It's true, she's not a queen, she's a dictator. Cold, selfish, tyrannical. She does not deserve your compassion, and most of all, does not deserve this crown.
The thing about being a hero, you're not supposed to rescue more than one damsel in a night.
I'm a registered nurse.
This is an embarrassment of riches, man. I swear.
Oh, J-Man, you okay?
I don't know, man. I don't feel good.
Just wait right here. I'm gonna go get you some water.
No, don't.
Jordy? Jordy.
Jordy, are you okay, honey? Come on. Oh, my God. Something's really wrong with him. I've never seen him like this.
It's the chemo. This is just one of the side effects.
Those stupid pamphlets you gave me said he wouldn't be sick in the first 24 hours.
Well, that is often true. But no two cases are the same. We can never predict how someone's body's going to react.
How long would this last?
Could be as long as his chemo regimen.
Thank you.
I'll get you some more towels.
I got enough! That's better.
So, what do you think?
It's exactly how I imagined homecoming would be. Even if you are just friends, the rule is you dance with the girl you brought.
Are you sure you don't want anything? A little blanket, some snacks.
No, I'm good. Just sit with me.
Ginger ale. The carbonation might be good for your stomach.
Mom, I don't want ginger ale.
Maybe not now. For later. I'll be right back, okay?
You okay?
Why wouldn't I be? Translation, I'm super pissed at you.
We didn't say much on the drive back.
Why did you go up there and defend Kara?
Because she was having a bad night?
She deserves a bad night, Leo. She's a bad person.
Maybe, but no one deserves to be pitied. You don't understand that because, well, no one pities you, Emma. You don't have to be in this hospital. You don't have to be here.
I can taste it in my mouth. I
breathe relief to call my name for the first time. Cry your eyes out, fill your lungs up. We all hurt, we all lie, and nothing stays the same. Let your guard down, get your heart.
Jackson, hey, can I talk to you for a second?
Actually, I've been looking for you. I wanted to apologize. I was wrong about Eva. Don't give me that look. Yes, Eva and I make mistakes.
Not this time. Eva left last night.
What's this?
She is relinquishing guardianship of Jordy. He's officially on his way to becoming an emancipated minor.
Which is just a fancy word for a loan.
So, I'm the one who needs to apologize to you. I'm sorry for not trusting your instincts.
We both want the same thing. What's best for Jordy?
I guess he's ours now.
He was ours the second he walked through that door.
I have the 411 on what happened after you left homecoming.
Don't care.
Okay, well, I also have a 411 on Anna's progress after your wheelchair crushed her.
Don't care. I don't care about the Crooked Girl or Homecoming or Paradise Cove High. I'm never going back there.
Wait. Really?
Really. You are officially relieved of your duties as Minion.
Well, can I still come visit you, like, just as your friend?
It's a free country, so do whatever you want.
If next week isn't good, we can try for the week after. I'll give him a call.
No, you don't understand. I don't want Ty to train me ever.
How are you going to get that scholarship?
I'm not. I did a little more research, and every article on Ty starts with the incredible story of his disease.
That's because he's made a remarkable recovery. He beat impossible odds, just like you will.
I'm not going to be the soccer player who survived cancer. You know, the guy they parade out at halftime like some fuzzy mascot and gives inspirational speeches. Because I'm not a sob story. I just want to be a regular guy.
lot about this concept of home. Doesn't have to be who you once were. There's a chance to make it all new. Start again and give it another chance. Or what you did or where you're from. Why are you living? What are you missing? Home just might be the feeling you get around the people that care about you the most. And if that's the case, you might already be home.
They're coming today, aren't they?
There is no foreseeable evidence that he will come out of his coma.
What about the interventions we haven't even tried yet?
Dad? It is our recommendation that Charlie be removed from the acute hospital setting.
We have to go now.
I'm not leaving you, Charlie, okay?
I made a promise to that little boy, a promise I intend to keep.
Scared. When you wake up, I will be right here. I promise you that. I'll be right here.
The murder mystery event continues, and everyone is a suspect. Grace Point is all new tomorrow.